Are you suffering from intense sharp pain at the back of your neck, radiating to your forehead, or at one side of your neck or shoulder? Hi, my name is Annie and welcome to my channel, Annie Pilates Physical Therapist. I'll be demonstrating some simple treatment plans for occipital neuralgia, which is an injury at the base of your skull area on your C1 or C2 level that creates this inflammation of chronic pain and weakness. So get your mat ready and a pillowcase or a scarf to join me today. So let's discuss a little bit about occipital neuralgia. So occipital neuralgia is an injury at the base of your skull where your spinal cord going all the way up at the starting point where it attaches before it goes to your brain area. So C1, C2 level is the highest of your cervical spine, and it's also the part of the spine that's very important to hold your head. And there's nerves coming out at that C1, C2 level that helps radiate sensation to the skull area, the base of your neck, that creates tension, headaches, as well as difficulty turning your neck, usually on the side of injury. But if it's becoming so chronic, it can be tight and stiff on both sides. And the muscles that supports the neck are the scalenes, vertebral scapulae, suboccipital muscles. So these muscles needs to be strong. Postural muscles have that injury, it creates this weakness. Usually on one side, if you have shoulder injury, it also creates this tension of weakness that pulls your neck down to one side. So no matter how much you stretch, if you don't stabilize your neck and strengthen, then these nerves that comes out of the C1, C2 level gets re-inflamed, and you have this chronic cycle of never-ending pain. So what are the symptoms of occipital neuralgia? Usually is pain at the base of the scalp, the neck area, sensitivity to light, stabbing pain behind your eye, tenderness on your scalp, and difficulty moving your neck. So what are the causes of occipital neuralgia? Number one reason could be a whiplash, trauma on your neck area. Someone gave you a back blow behind your head. If you have osteoarthritis, tight neck because of poor posture, if you have tumors near your neck, diabetes, and other factors that create this tension around the base of your head. So how can you diagnose if you have occipital neuralgia? It is best to see your doctor still or your local physical therapist, and they will do special tests to check where the pain is coming from. Having diagnostic imaging such as MRI will help us understand more if you have any disc inflammation creates this narrowing of the canal of your foramen where the nerve comes out. So my recommendation, please see your doctor or your physical therapist before you start any treatment. It is also best when you speak to your doctor that they will recommend some muscle relaxants, anti-inflammatory drugs, and pain medication, so it will help you sleep well. And if you're sleeping well, guess what? You are healing. So you want to make sure you combine all of these factors, because it's really painful having this symptom. It could take you months or years if you don't treat it properly. So in this video, I will show you how to do step-by-step guide on how I can fix my patients who had occipital neuralgia for many months and finally found relief utilizing my techniques of Pilates, yoga, and physical therapy, controlled movement patterns that's perfect for you, finding the sweet spot that works best for you. So most of my patients doing back extension with the gentle rotation, when you feel there's less sharp pain, is the best movement for my patients. So it's important to do some assessment first. So if you find out you have injury on your left side and you have more pain going down on one side, it is best to check which movement pattern creates pain. If there's more pain, stop. Means you have to limit that movement. You have to find centralization of pain, which means if the pain goes down further the shoulder or goes more towards your forehead or the scalp area, then you are making it worse. Example, if I'm turning my head to the right and my injury is on the left, and I feel like it's a regular pain, but just pinching pain in the area without radiating going down the shoulder, then that's safe. And then when I turn to the left, just gently, and I feel like sharp pain going down on that side, then stop. You have to continue away from the pain. And once you feel a little bit better, you can always test it again. After a few days, then test the limit. Core stretching is important, myofascial release, as well as placing some heat on your neck for at least 20 minutes before you do your exercises, at the same time before someone massages your neck. You can also do some simple neck stretches and snag techniques. So snag is a lovely way to help pull your neck almost yourself, manual traction that you can use. You can do utilizing a scarf or a pillowcase. So you can get a pillowcase again with the exercises. Let's start with snag techniques. So at the base of the skull, you can use the edge of your pillowcase. I'm using this side. And I'm gonna gently pressure at the base of my skull near your ear area. You're pressing a little bit on your ear to pull it further in the middle. As you slowly look up for extension, as I look up, I breathe in. And as I let go, exhale. Hold that 5 seconds, hold 10 times. So that's one towards extension. And now we're gonna do rotation. Gently extend and slowly turn to one side. So if your painful side is in your left, turn away first towards the right. I'm pulling it towards my jaw area. Slight rotation with a tilt with a gentle extension and hold that as well. 5 seconds, hold 10 times. Now let's face the painful side towards the left where you have the most limited motion. So snag, extension first. Then now my right hand towards the left, I'm going to pull it towards my face, my cheek and jaw with a gentle tilt. And once you feel the range at the end range, hold that. 5 seconds, hold 10 times. And after doing both ways and extension, now it's best to do a little bit side bending. So if your painful side is your left, you're going to place the pillowcase on your shoulder. One hand at the back and one in the front. So you want to make sure you're going to pull tension downward. So I'm going to pull it down, hold it there for 5 seconds, hold, and then gently tilt away to feel that scalene stretch. You can feel that all the way down to your shoulder, 5 seconds, hold 10 times. And after doing the bad side, it's best to check the opposite side as well. So one hand in the front, a little bit internal rotation. The back hand, gently pull it down and make sure it's on the top of your shoulder near your clavicle. And you're gonna feel the end of this neck area where you're gonna pull some tension as you pull it down for 5 seconds, hold, and then gently tilt away, side bend. 5 seconds, hold 10 times. So after those gentle stretches, it is best with occipital neuralgia to stabilize your neck. So isometrics is so important. So with neck isometrics, you're gonna use your hand first. Start on the good side. As you gently press towards the temporal area of your skull, keeping your head neutral, you can do it in the front of the mirror so you can see your posture. Hold that for 5 seconds, hold 10 times. If 5 seconds hold is creating pain, you can start 1 to 2 seconds and then slowly progress 5 seconds. Then do the other side. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 10 times. And you feel one side a little bit much more difficult and weaker, and that's fine. So you'll know how to catch up on the good side. Now is flexion on your forehead, keeping your head straight. Hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm using my right hand. If your weaker side is your left, then use your stronger arm so you're not straining your neck. Now, clasp your fingers, place it behind your head, and gently press forward, keeping your head straight. For your neck extensors, hold that for 5 seconds, hold. And now with a little bit dynamic movement, a little bit 45 degree angle, not full rotation, just diagonal. And then pressure again at the temporal area and hold that five seconds, hold 10 times and turn towards the injured side, 5 seconds, hold 10 times. And once the isometrics gets easier, then you can utilize elastic band wraps around your head with different resistance as you get stronger. And after doing those neck isometrics, then we can do some yoga. Hands and knees position. Hands level to your shoulders, knees towards your hips. Cat and camel is my favorite. As you round, inhale. As you exhale, slowly lower your chest and then fully extend looking up. Again, inhale, looking down, chin tuck, belly button in, engage your core muscles, and exhale, looking up. And my recommendation is at 8 times only. Strengthening your core, improving your posture is best if you have occipital neuralgia. No matter how much we fix the neck, if your core and glutes and the rest of your body is tight, it will definitely not help your recovery if you don't start doing other movement patterns. After doing cat and camel, then you can do thread the needle by doing beginners only. Just twisting on one side and then down. So I'm not lifting my arm yet for beginners. Again, just twisting and down. And do that 5 seconds hold 10 times. The last exercise is child pose. Lowering your hips, extending your arms forward and hold that 30 seconds hold 3 times. With your deep breathing. And you can progress by doing puppy pose, by extending your hand at the edge of the mat, lowering your chest down, keeping your hips up, and lowering your chest. Hold that for 10 seconds, hold for beginners to progress to 30 seconds. And making sure your forehead is resting on the mat. Do that 3 times. And this is only demonstration only. If you want a follow along video, leave a comment down below, direct message me on my social media, description link down below, and try my best to answer each one of you. And I have more variety of exercises you can do for your neck. Here's the link for your neck disc progression, utilizing elastic band that you can find out, and more yoga poses as you gentle progress. If you love this video and you find value about Pilates, yoga, and physical therapy, health, and wellness, please subscribe to my channel. Ring the bell so you won't miss anything. Like and share this video if you want to support me. Every like helps me improve my channel. Always remember, be safe, be well, and healthier you. Until my next video, bye!